My name is Mark Irwin, and I'm the Director of Maintenance for Bison Transport. And I'd like to go through some of the new improvements we've made on the trailers and how that has impacted our organization. The industry standard has been in the northern parts of United States and Canada around 10 years. With our improvements, we're able to get 15 years life cycle out of this. According to the manufacturer, they're suggesting 20 years. Once you see the improvements that we have made, you'll have the confidence we have as well. So let me take you through some of the improvements we've made. First of all, on the front of the trailer, you're going to see a very standard format. Everything will be consistent going forward. We have the electrical junction box, the seven-way electrical junction box, now with the ability to rotate to reduce any kind of electrical cable tension, also providing durability for the seven-way connector from the truck to the trailer. Our glide hand fittings are on spring loaded, and they will close and keep all debris out of the airlines while the trailer is in storage and the heater is operating. Everything all around the front of the bottom of the trailer here is now galvanized. And if you want to know the durability of galvanization, take a look at the guardrails at the side of the road. Guardrails that have been up for 30 plus years, still rust free. And this is what we have done on the foundation of our trailers now. The front nose wrap is all galvanized. The bottom coupler plate is also galvanized. Galvanization actually reduces friction by 20%. And this reduction of friction on the coupler plates means that we'd probably be using less grease. Along the heater and our heater control, we've made noticeable improvements, not only on the design of the box, but also on the design of the heater itself. So what we've done here is we've tried to maximize our airflow within the box itself. And traditionally, the heater intake is right here. And then the exhaust of the heater, the hot air, comes out of the top. We tried to separate the intake and the exhaust by adding this bulkhead that has pockets allowing the fresh air or the cooler air to come back into the heater. This will create a full cycle of air currents within the trailer for maximizing heater proficiencies. We now operate this heater with 50% less fuel required, and we can predict the durability or the length of time this heater is going to actually operate. It's one thing to build a trailer that is capable of meeting a 15-year life cycle, and if our heater doesn't last the entire 15 years, we haven't accomplished anything. One of the challenges that the maintenance department would have if there was any kind of electrical problems and the trailer is loaded was gaining access to the wiring harness. We have now segmented the wiring harness so it would be a plug and play. And along with that is we have cut access holes all along the bottom side of this coupler plate so that at any point we can access the wiring harness completely outside without having to disturb a loaded trailer. We've made a notable improvement on the landing gear. We've increased the landing gear capacity for reliability, and you'll notice that this whole landing gear sub-assembly is all galvanized as well. This will reduce corrosion and make it very easy to change out. One thing in particular, you'll notice that the whole landing suspension is now bolted on. Traditionally it was welded on, now it is bolted. The amount of time required to change out the landing legs is reduced by at least 50%. One of the unique things we've partnered with is a company called ProLam. ProLam manufactures flooring that has a hard plastic bonded right to the bottom side of the trailer. Our objective is to ensure that the bottom side of this trailer sees no moisture whatsoever. This is to prevent any kind of floor rotting and increase their durability. That is a hard plastic, about a 16th of an inch thick barrier between the wood and the elements. You can see this trailer is a working trailer and there is dirt on it, but there will be no water penetrating that floor. So what we've done here is we've added aluminum cross members for weight reduction and allowing us to carry more capacity. In order for us to maintain the weight capacity that we carry, we've actually had to increase the bottom of the aluminum rails. Traditionally, the bottom aluminum rail would be maybe a quarter to half the thickness of this bottom rail. We'd be ending up with a 12,000 pound floor rating under the traditional aluminum floors. This gives us a rolling dynamic weight capacity of 18,000 pounds. And over here, where the traditional galvanized steel is and the aluminum mounts to the aluminum rail, we've put in 10 millimeter thick mylar. This 10 millimeter thick mylar is over three times the thickness of the traditional mylar. Normal manufacturing is done with 3 mil mylar, and we now have 10 mil. This gives us that added protection for corrosion between the two dissimilar metals. Earlier on, I mentioned that we had galvanizing, and when galvanizing takes effect, some of the benefits of the galvanizing is a reduction of metal friction. We now have galvanizing along our slider rails. This metal reduction is about 20% improvement just by coating the metal with something that has a lubrication built right into the top coating. So it makes it a lot easier for the drivers to slide bogies. So what we have here is the TireMax Pro system. It is part of the tire inflation system where it has the ability to inflate and deflate as required. And this is the indicator light telling the driver that the system is operating and that it's either inflating or deflating the tires as required. It will also tell the driver whether or not they have a slow air leak and that maintenance will be required. Tire inflation has a huge impact on the ability and the performance of a tire. What will happen when operating at an air temperature at minus 35 is that the traditional tire inflation systems would inflate a tire, and by the time the tire moves into temperatures of plus 20 Celsius, there's about a 30% increase in pressure, operating pressure. That will cause abnormal tire wear. Bison Transport was one of the first Canadian fleets to install the TireMax Pro system. We saw the benefits of having tires operating at their peak performance all the way through their trips. Along with that, we have safety links applied to each of our wheel studs. And the design of those safety links are to maintain torque pressure on each of these wheel studs. And in the event that one of those nuts may come loose, they can only come loose a small fraction. And when they come loose, they would be very quick to identify to the driver as he's doing his circle check that we have a potential wheel stud that is loose. So they work extremely well for us. Beneath this, the wheel end or the hub is also a very high tensile steel, but lightweight, built to last the life cycle of this trailer. We have used to use aluminum hubs, and we had a replacement plan for those every 8 years. We now have been able to come up with a hub on the market that will give us our life cycle that we're looking for. The aluminum rim, very lightweight, reduces overall weight of the trailer. The brake drum underneath this is a very lightweight, high tensile brake drum as well, also designed to reduce overall weight. We're also in the process of testing out the aerodynamic efficiencies of mud flaps and the impact that it will have. This is obviously a very perforated mud flap, and it allows the air to travel through, but not the water and the road debris. This is under test and we're in the process of evaluating it. In order to make things simpler for our drivers, We've gone to the extent of standardizing these placard holders. That means height and position. Sometimes you'll find these placards all over the side of the trailers. We've standardized it to make it more user-friendly for our drivers. We have a specking committee that consists of drivers, key players such as safety, maintenance is a part of that, operations is also a part of that. And what we heard from the specking committee, especially the drivers, is how can we make connecting the converter dollies to the back of these trailers easier for them. And we have done that by relocating the airlines off to one side. No longer do they have to come over to the other side to connect up one airline and have another airline on this side. We've tried to group them all together to make it very convenient for them. With the back of this trailer, you will notice that there are bolts all along. You can see the nuts and bolts even on this side, the stairs, they're all very simple to replace. These bolts are designed so that if there's an impact or an accident that occurs, the amount of time to replace this bumper on a maintenance side is about 30 minutes at this point in time. As a result of having a very quick maintenance repair done on this trailer, it means less downtime for the drivers, quicker turnaround, easy application to get the drivers up and running again. You can see that every one of our new pieces of equipment coming into our fleet is standard with the pintle hitch assembly. We've incorporated top rail lights. They're actually brake lights and turn signal lights. The top three lights are the brake lights, and the right and left are their turn signal lights. That is very new to the industry. There are two areas of heat loss within the trailer that we can influence. And the most economical area we can influence is the trailer door. Traditionally, a trailer door would be 1-inch insulation with 2 lip seals. What we've done different this time is we have a 3-inch door with 4 lip seals for heat loss protection. This allows us to operate the heater much less while maintaining and protect from freeze condition. In the interest of safety, we want to maintain 3-point contact at all times while entering into the trailer. We now have an additional strap for the drivers to be able to maintain that 3-point contact as they enter in. As we talked earlier about the floor and the protection that we have underneath the floor, we have also added additional protection on top of the floor. The last 8 feet of this floor, as you can see, it's a working floor. There's lots of scratches and bruises in it right now. But the last 8 feet of this floor has been heated up and then dipped into hot wax. The whole objective behind this is to keep it watertight for the working zone, the transition zone from outside to inside, so that this floor will remain free from wood rot in the working areas. With the interest of trying to reduce loss heat through the walls, we've added not only the block foam behind and between each of these posts, but we have injected polyurethane behind the post. That heat transfer is now insulated and is not a direct leakage like it has been in the past. Just another efficiency to reduce the heater operation.